Viral size is actually very important entity of the virus, because the viruses are, as we studied in last time, that viruses are have a quite wide range of the size. Similarly, they have also have quite big range of the structure. As we studied two different kind of viruses, just like the influenza virus and bacteriophage virus, they are quite different kind of structures. Similarly, the size, we have also studied about the foot and mouth disease virus, which is an animal virus for the cattle viruses, and the other viruses we have studied, the polio virus, which is a human virus. They are quite different. The polio virus is 300 nanometer, while the foot and mouth disease virus is only 27 nanometer. So we have studied that the viral size is very important as far as, so how we determine the virus size, how we studied and how we determine it. Viral size is determined by the electron microscopy. As you already know, that viruses are not possible to see with the simple microscope. You have to use the electron microscope. So with the electron microscopy, you can determine that what, how much the virus is big. They vary in size and they have the big range of the viruses, just like we studied. For example, we will see in the next slide that different viruses have different sizes. But one important character is the most of the viruses are smaller than the bacteria. Most of the viruses, we cannot say it's a basic principle, but most of them are smaller than the bacteria. Some are as same size of the bacteria. For example, the vaccinia virus is about same as big as the bacteria are, but most of them are the smaller than the bacteria. So here is here are some example of the viruses, their size and as well as their shapes. Just like you can see the Streptococcus bacterium, that is seen on the one side of the slide, and that is the biggest virus we can see in this slide. Similarly, the bacterium E. coli. E. coli is the Escherichia coli, is the most important virus as far as for the molecular biology point of view. We will study it more and more, and it's very easy, very much used for the molecular biology experiments and for the bacteriological different experiments in the laboratories. So you can see that its size is also big. Similarly, the eukaryotic yeast cell is also being used a lot in the molecular biology experiments. Then the polio virus, herpes virus, rabies virus, HIV, influenza, adenovirus, polyvirus, poliovirus, and then the flaviviruses. So these are the viruses which are arranged from the size point of view. So you can see the variability in the size of different viruses. The biggest one is the eukaryotic yeast cells in this range. And then you can see the other virus of the pox virus, which is the bigger than the eukaryotic cells, and then the herpes virus is smaller than the pox virus, rabies virus is smaller than the herpes virus, then HIV is smaller than the rabies, influenza virus is smaller than HIV, and the adenovirus is smaller than influenza, and virus polio is smaller than the adenovirus. Similarly, the flaviviruses are the smaller than the even the polio viruses. You can see this is in the presentation in front of you, that these viruses are arranged according to the sizes, according to their sizes. Similarly, one more example of the size of viruses is also seen here. For example, we have seen the viruses, and we have given the viruses size here. Bacteriophage is 2 to 5 nanometer in size. Similarly, the rabies virus is 170 into 70 nanometer in size. So there are different sizes of the different viruses. Adenovirus is 90 nanometer, rhinovirus is 30 nanometer, very small. Similarly, the bacteriophages, first we take the example of the T4, that is 2 to 5 nanometer. Now the bacteriophages MS2 is 24 nanometer. So you can see the versatility of the size between same kind of the viruses. The T4 virus and the MS2 virus, they are totally different and their size is different. Polioviruses, and there are some kind of prions these days which are very important. They are also 200 into 20 nanometers, and vaccinia virus, they are about similar to the size of the bacteria. They are 300 into 200 into 100 nanometers. And now we can see the Ebola virus, that is 970 nanometers in size. E. coli, plasma membrane of the red blood cells, this is the, these are the different viruses which are different in the size from the smallest to the biggest one of the viruses.